Yeah.
This is.
It's important that
this is really
that Professor
close.
Pro does work now.
He's done some already. She's up to 60. It's not Dreamland, so not. He living. Professor Pro keeping him busy, left hand recovering.
Yeah, that was a good choice. They could have drilled shined him though, as an infinite.
You can. Oh,
that's yeah!
He's out. That's it.
And they take it.
Left hand Professor Pro, winners of UD8 in a long grand finals.
And now
which
we
I
have singles.
Had the joy of commenting together with you, Hag.
Yep, this was an honor.
Leffen blowing out air.
Yeah.
Hyping together with Professor Pro. They must be happy about that one. It's really rough to play long games with Armada. You have to be so on point.
Alright, so I think singles is gonna start now. So should me versus Rocky play? Alright, I'm signing off and going to find Rocky. We need another commentator here, so...
Yes. Is Mike Hagar still in the tournament?
Nope.
He is not. Then I'm going to stand up and look for Mike Hagar.
Rocky!
Discussing who's gonna play on stream and who's not, because it's pretty late, so we're gonna get things wrapped up. For stream, eller? Alright, so we're gonna get Armada and Kaladavu on stream. Yes, and we need one more for commentating, and the votes are going to Mike Hagar, I might assume. And Lex is gonna go to pick him up now. Not sure if I'm gonna commentate together with Mike Hagar. I like the guy. But I don't know, maybe someone else is better than me at commentating. Lolex is approaching Mike Hagar. Talking to maybe Randomness would like to commentate. I think Randomness and Mike Hagar is a good duo for commentating. I would like to watch that. I'm gonna go and watch the stream chat if I can see anything. Or I think this is on a projector. I don't want to touch anything. Never mind, folks. Kaladavu up on stage together with Randomness. Ska du kommentera med KJU? Nej, okej. Randomness. Randomness wants to watch and not commentate. I like to watch. I'm going to scream at Mike Hagar, so I'm going to remove the headset. Ladies and gentlemen, we are stuck with me. Everyone else is really tired! I'm pretty tired as well, but yeah. I'm gonna keep my notes so I don't fuck up again. Kaladavu on stage, pretty sure Armada wants a short break after teams. Especially since you've got two sets in a row. Kaladavu representing Heroes of New Earth. Best MOBA. I don't know for how long we have to wait. Because as we know, Armada wants to have a break. Armada is now coming back on stage. He's talking with Lolix. Shaking hands with Daniolas, probably have been discussing the set. Pretty interested to see how W play now, as we said before. They want to break the fourth curse. They didn't against Solar and Android, but he has the same chance. It seems that I'm getting the backup from Android!
Substream!
What's up?
Sup, babe? Well. So, how are you doing?
So, third place in teams! Feeling good? I think. Yeah, it's okay. It was a few mistakes we did, but overall, I think we did pretty well.
Yeah. Always nice to see your needle saves. Was continuing comment while watching.
Those needles, man!
So they're going to Battlefield, Armada, Kel, and W.
They're going right away, okay.
They usually play a lot, like.
I can't hear you, can you move closer?
Yeah, sure.
Move close to me, man.
Yeah.
I wanna smell you!
Now, what I said was, they usually to play a lot in like back in the days before Leffen became second best.
Armada and KOTW?
Yeah.
Yeah, they've been playing forever. I still remember from like before we were going to Genesis 2 on the road trip on a tournament and. No, not Genesis 2. Like, I think the first time Armada went to the States. Before that we had a tournament and KOTW was coming from the loser bracket, but he took the first set from Armada. So it's been, that was a long time ago. But now KOTW said that I am as hype as I was at 2008, and that's when he was considered top 5 in Europe. So really looking forward to this set. I think it's gonna be
nice for KOTW.
Really even. Patience.
Back air.
See if he gets this edge guard.
And let
edgeguard pinch as Falco, right? You can't really jump out to like, I'm gonna fuck you.
No.
Because if you mess up once, then you're dead.
Yeah, you have to like be patient, really wait until she do something.
Yes.
Up throw. Continue with up throw. Dash attack. Pretty close with fair. And gets a back air and she's dead.
Well traded by KOTW.
Yep.
That cancel.
Really nice.
He just wants to get a few fast percent now before he dies. Let's see if he can make it happen.
Or take the stock. Oh, really? That was really close. And down smash and he's dead.
Got 39 at least. I think it's enough to start up tilting. Yes.
Yep. Dash attack. Real nice crouch cancel by KOTW.
I think, would you say Falco is like one of the best characters at making stuff happen when the enemy is at low percent? Because like Marth and Sheik, if you get to someone and they're like at like 0%, you have to do some, like the first percent, especially for Sheik, are so tricky to get, because so that's why you always like, you just down throw and throw needles because you want to get through those first percent. After like when you get to like 30 or 40, it's a lot easier to make shit happen.
Yeah. But yeah.
Falco can just like, I don't care what your percent you're at, I'm gonna fuck you.
Yeah, he shines really like, it doesn't matter what kind of percent you are. Because Falco can always follow up.
What can Sheik do at low percent? Apart from down smash.
Well, I can answer right after this match.
to not stop.
T-chat 163. Represent.
Getting a down smash. Illusion and Nair. Cover. Pretty close. Call W. Illusion.
Nice recovery by Call W. Mixing up. But I'm modest. One step ahead. Gets the grab and the snipe.
Yeah. But yeah, to answer your question, what you have to do is like to be really patient. Maybe do like needles, grab, or like back air, forward hand, short up.
I hate that when you're about to sneeze and you're like, it's coming. But when you think about it, it stops, and then you have this like tingling in your nose, and you're like, just sneeze, fuck. Okay, Yoshi story, it looks like.
Yeah, Yoshi
solid
story.
Solid counterpick from Falco.
Yeah.
As long as you got that down smash on the platforms.
Oh, back air.
Game, but back. He gets hit by up B and
yeah, he
makes it back.
Up throw.
Misses the wave land. This is gonna.
Down air. Pretty
Amara
close.
Knows about that.
And now, Call W.
Call W is so aggressive with his up B's.
Nice.
Crowd's getting into it.
Really, really good play by Call W. Upper, and fair.
Armada on par with this punish game. On point. The down smash, quick 40%. You don't want to get hit like that when you're shining.
Up throw. You are.
This might hurt, but Call W jumps out. Very nice.
Back air. Turnip.
Snipe.
There. And there. Yeah. Pretty good. Pretty good. The crouch cancel, as a Falco, is really good to crouch cancel stuff. You really have to do that. I think so, with Falco. Or at least mix it up. But he gets a huge advantage when crouch cancel. Because if you start to approach, then he can get the shine or down smash or anything from it.
Yes.
Like, you get a free hit, but he will punish you for you try to take that chance.
Yeah.
And Call W do that.
Call W going really far out. Oh man.
Yeah.
But he gets punished. But he needed to do something like that when you're three stocks behind. You can't play safe when you're that far behind.
You have to.
Need to make shit happen.
Take a chance. Yeah. Even if there's really risky, you have to do it.
The Jigglypuff taunt.
But yeah, he goes to Pokemon Stadium.
Call W is struggling to get that combo starter in. He just gets one or two hits and lasers. No! He got something, but didn't convert.
Up throw. Dash attack. Bear
Armada
and
is
air.
Getting. When he gets a hit, it's five more hits. Call W is not getting anything started right now.
36.
He's looking for something with his laser. That's up tilt. Now he's gonna get a lot.
Call W is pretty good to like pressure
in his head.
I really like the Call W is like put such a pressure on the edge.
Yes, mental pressure.
Mental pressure. That's really
but
really fun to see.
Doesn't work on Armada, it seems like. As Armada takes a second stock from Call W, he needs to.
Ooh, and that taunt.
Call W.
Nah.
He's enjoying this. I feel like it's tricky to
Whoa.
Get
Damn.
The finish off of Falco. He wants to combo into the finish, but now when he pitches his high percent, like, exactly, he had to go high enough for up tilt to kill. When Pitch is at like 100, I don't know what Falco is supposed to do, unless he finds an opportunity for forward smash, but. Double jumps out of dash attack, preventing like 2 million damage from Armada. Up tilt. Armada is one step ahead. Nice
really
short by
nice
Kill W.
Yeah. Up throw to another, to four throw.
If she gets the Armada got the snipe. Kill W makes it back anyway.
Ramona, you cannot forget your sniper home.
Yeah.
You need
Swedish
that one.
Snipe. Oh yes, of course. Down tilt kills pretty early too.
Back air.
The bear got hit. I think he wanted to slip off the dare, but
another stitch face. But yeah, whatever. Fuck that one.
He'll get a bob bomb eventually. No worries. Throw away the stitched face, grab a bob bomb, easy rares, easy life. Double bear from Armada, rough punish.
Weak nair.
Oh, that should be it. No.
He
nice
dead.
Recovery by Kalw stalling with up to make the snipe hit.
Really
Armada
good.
Is too good at space guarding. Falco. 3-0 Armada. Kalw unplugs controller, looks me in the eye. Tells me he loves me. Easy rares, easy life. As Armada finishes his juice.
Yep.
Leffen and Beat is going to play. Looking forward to see how Beat handles Leffen.
Yeah,
as someone who just switched to Marth, I want to look at Beach as much as I can.
Leffen is one of the best player like in around top 10.
Yes.
He's probably like, yeah, he's top the top 10, I would like to say. And yeah, Beach has improved a lot for the last few months. Really, like, came
his
to
best matchup is against Fox too, as everyone's been stating. That's why he managed to beat Professor Pro. Because he plays against a lot of Fox, he knows how to handle Fox as a Marth, which I do not. How much do you know about the Marth Fox matchup? Except well. From A.
Well, I don't know. I think
Beat opened up my eyes to the dash attack a lot more. I felt like it wasn't really safe enough to use. Because you can get punished so damn hard when you're playing against Fox, but whenever he hits a dash attack, he gets so much from it, so the risk reward seems to be worth it.
Yeah. Leffen pressure Beat, a lot on the edge.
Manages to make it back, that's a tricky situation to get back from, but not that time.
Yeah.
Leffen not dropping. Misses the get up attack. Risky
up
to go for
throw, up throw.
Nope.
Up tilt. Nice combo. Unfortunately, he couldn't follow up, but he.
Nice DI by Leffen.
He takes another chance.
Time, but he missed that DI.
He did. Really good by Beat. Like, once you get one thing, and we saw it, like, when he played against Professor Pro, that once you get, like, a grab. He also have practiced his punish.
Yes.
Punish. Punish.
Nice mix up by Beat to go for a back throw after up throwing because you're not ready to take.
And yes, nice edge guard by Beat. Nice edge.
No one suspects the daring pal.
Ah,
he messed up, but
reverse
so did
shine.
He managed to live.
Up throw.
Nice.
Down.
Well played by Leffen, he didn't manage to cover that.
Oh.
Nice. That's how you use the counter. You don't use it all the time, you use it when you know they're gonna pass you with the up-beat. So you can't switch bottom. Well played by Beat.
So
with
Leffen's
the lead right
last
now,
stock.
Might get this game. Doesn't. Let's see if Beat catches up on. Leffen's done the same thing twice though, that he double jumps up and air dodges through Beat's punish. If he catches up on that, he might be able to get a game pop on Leffen.
Let's see. You are.
This hurts. Good.
Be careful, Beat. Oh. But yeah, nice work from Beat.
2-0 for Beat against Leffen.
1-0.
I don't know, I meant two stocks.
Yeah,
I
figured that out.
Leffen going to 3, man. A rough stage for Marth, as he can't really wreck you on the platforms. Quick 60% for Leffen.
Reverse bear.
Beat, not smash the eyeing up airs. Crucial to do. Smash up.
and a prayer.
Leffen capitalizing on that. Leffen adapts really fast to that kind of stuff. If you start smash during the up air, he's gonna start going for bear instead. But you need to do it anyway, because bear doesn't do it much as up air. You need to force him into the worse decision. Nice grab, but he didn't go off stage, so down tilt doesn't hit. This is rough, and nice. This gets both of the edge guards. Beat manages to use Nair as an approach against spaces. Huh. That's really nice because normally you don't go down into Nair too fast because it auto cancels if you don't. But he uses it well against space animals to approach. It's really good.
Nice trying with by left.
You almost always have to hit the enemy when you're up being with Martin because otherwise it's such an easy edge guard to wreck. You need to hit him the up being. And he tried to do it early to hit him, but he got China. Because Leffen knew that was gonna happen. And stage advantage showing as Leffen quickly 3-0 beat. That was a really fast game.
Yeah.
And no surprise, beat goes to Final Destination. Leffen really good at not getting grabbed though, as we saw. Previous beauty tournament, I think, when everyone got wrecked by an Ice Climbers player, and Leffen just said, "You just don't get grabbed," and then he force stalked him twice.
Nice, but he's that was pretty, like, there was barely. Whoa, okay.
Deciding to go off stage to protect himself against it's a lot of Fox. Up smash hitting. Baiting out the grab into up smash to the face.
Beat plays a lot on the edge, like the edge game on Fox. We've seen it. Like,
I'm pretty sure that fair was on purpose, right? He up throwed and then he fared because it does 20% and you might get a follow up. Normally bear's pretty good, but fair works as well. Especially if you're not ready for it, it's gonna throw you off.
Nice for
not getting the tipper, so he has to get his edge guard.
Okay. But he's making it back.
Oh, down nice tilt. Down air. I mean, tipper. Down tilt. Living. Nice side B, dodging the up air. Trying to bait
really
out
dangerous.
Stuff. Left and gets the up.
One single hit and Leffen is probably.
He smashed like that upper though, but Leffen's space is too good.
He gets a phantom hit.
He should get him now anyway, yes.
But yeah, he did, but.
2-2, Final Destination. Mark does not like to lose here against Fox, and he's gonna do his best. Leffen just trying to get him to the percent where up throw up air kills now, exactly. That's the best way to use Laser Beast Fox, I think, when you're like in between those percentages where you can do stuff. Marth was not on combo percentage, but he was not on kill percentage either, just a few lasers to get him up to that.
Can we get a real Marth? I wanted to see like a really like 20 or 0 to death combo. But yeah, Leffen has a high percent anyway. Ain't?
Nice. Beat went for the up smash.
Nice.
I mean, forward smash because you wanted to go into edge guard, not rather than a rack up percent. Managed to get it.
This is close.
Needs to get a grab or something here though, because he is very close to. Now he is at up throw into up air killing percent. Or maybe one or two more aces, not sure.
Yeah.
Edge guard and Leffen takes the second game as well, beating Marth on his favorite stage.
2-1.
Where do you go here? Do you go back to Final Destination?
Yeah.
I think you have to. It's your best stage.
Yeah. So, 2-1. Leffen has the lead.
What?
Let's see. And he gets the up throw, up tilt.
Leffen knows when he can jump out, and he does. Going for the edge guard rather than racking up percent. did not pay off. Nathan messes up though and gets upbeat and dies.
He's dead, yeah.
Still not smash dying Jaffers. Defense getting a lot of percentage from that.
Interesting.
That was really nice from me. That tipper was scary. Great. Now it's looking more like Marth on his own stage. Whoa! Entire crowd goes what? As
yeah,
Fox doesn't care about
Marth
before. Counter.
I've seen that before. Yeah, like the very. In a, not maybe exactly a specific angle, but sometimes, yeah, spaces somehow manage with up B, like dodge the down B. I have no idea really exactly how it works.
Shit happens, but then you tipper and they die.
But
so
the
no
game
problem.
Goes on, and Beats seems to still like push left into his lane.
That's the smash DI. I don't know if that's enough to make Leffen start using Bear instead. Nice stall with side B to dodge the up tilt, would have led into Baron kill.
Nice one.
Did not take percentage on that entire stock, could make a comeback here. And a second smash the eye, saving him a lot of percent. Lasers is looking for a percent where he can do stuff. He's now in killing percent. There you go. Really good use of lasers, by the way.
Yeah. So think careful now, Beats.
Beats pretty frustrated now, I assume. But now he gets the Marth stuff happening.
Nice one. Up to nice one. Good.
B grab, not nice. Really nice dash dance. He's a tipper. Ah, misses that. You can hear Beat smash the eye from all the way here now. He's slamming the controls. Does not like to get after it.
Oh, choke! Take the edge.
Nice volume tech from left. Presses himself against the wall to get the tech. Nair to get him off stage. That was close, but he gets the upper. Beat misses the smash the eye and left the
tech.
Leffen wins twice on Final Destination against Marth. Convincing.
There's a few things Beat did that was kind of interesting though. He played really good, but when Leffen has his last stock, he started to more like aerial stuff. He like jumped a fair and like Leffen punished that he was more on the air instead of on the ground. I know me as a Sheik, I can see that stuff. Me myself, I'm playing maybe too much in the air instead of the ground, because Sheik is much faster on the ground instead of the air. And I think Beat should have, or yeah, maybe it was just one like once it happened, but he should have been more on the ground and like dash dancing. But he started to be in the air and left and punished it pretty much for it.
Yeah. You're really vulnerable when you're in the air as Marth, because like each move is such a dedication. Like it reaches very far, but if you miss, you're fucked. You need to hit your shit with Marth, otherwise
so
you're gonna get punished.
Color W versus Professor Pro. This will be interesting.
It is now a matter of combos and gimps. Who's stronger? As Falco generally has better combos, but Fox has the Shire.
So they go on Yoshi's
Story. Going
to
Yoshi's Story, the space stage. Blip, blip, blip. Morse code. I love you looking for a shine to get stuff going.
Afro?
Right Backer. Now, Fox looking stronger on stage. This is not good for Falco. No Randall. He dead. Professor with slightly.
Really nice play.
Thunder's combo. To regram.
Knife one. A pro backer.
I realize now that we hear the sound before we see the screen here. So when the up throw, we heard the bear hit.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, he's gonna get the bear, and then we see the hit here.
Yeah.
Pretty annoying.
Yeah, I know. He wanted that.
Oh,
down
nice
volume
take for Todd up, you know. Saving the situation.
Nice spot dodge.
That's one of the things that really separates really good players from just good players. Even when you mess up, you're like, okay, I messed up, now I have to do something with this new thing that happened. So he didn't get to face like, oh, I missed the punish, I am now fucked. Instead he saw that, okay, I'm getting hit by a piece, so he managed to volley up things.
Ah, damn.
The lead is not as big anymore, as he is at 79. And not 40.
Down smash?
He dead.
He's dead.
Down smash, bad eye. Fox probably wanted to shine. KLW wants that first hit. Here it is.
Shine down
there.
Gonna
be a lot
now
of percent.
Now follows the combos. Pretty hard. That makes follows go pretty
That's
strong.
That's the KLW forward smash, and Professor Pro is back.
But
off stage.
Down smash, forward smash.
I'm going to use every smash in the game.
Calvary
makes it back. That's really nice because he's now going to get a lot of percentage. I'm going to save, but it ends up being 10.
Nice.
Nice use of Randall.
Yeah, KLW really like. He used the Cloud like really good. It's not so much.
KLW has a tattoo of Randall on his penis.
Well, anyway. KLW under the edge.
Nice use of Randall again. But Professor Pro gets him below the edge, and when you are up being against with Falco against Fox, you are dead.
Nice one by KLW.
KLW 1-0 against Professor Pro.
Är det okej om man boxar? Är det okej om man boxar en powerking? Ja.
Du vann, ja? Absolut.
And yeah, Professor Pro wants Pokémon Stadium as his counterpick.
Rush.
Thanks. This is really interesting.
Grab though. Oh, the pressure.
The pressure.
Shine. He wanted that up there. But yeah. This is a tight battle.
KLW is strolling around at the moment.
Just like
going back into the game shortly.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned as KLW side B cancels. Nice tick.
Up throw there. Nice. And he wants nice.
Should
good cover.
All options covered. There for the low angles. And forward smash for the others.
And he wanted that.
KLW likes to punish those things.
Really good. Really
never
good.
Instant jump as spaces if you when you can shine stall.
No.
Unless you have a specific plan. Did not pay off that time though.
Let's see. But it's not over, not at all. Prof can Prof can take this.
Fox is so like,
Prof can take this.
I don't care about the current state of the game, I'm going to shine spike it 3 times in a row at least.
Yep.
He is looking for it.
Shine.
He is approaching the stage. I mean the edge.
Back throw. Oh.
Denied.
Denied.
KLW dumpsters.
It's a 3-1 stock in KLW's favor. This is hard, even for a Fox.
Could happen though. Don't count out the Prof.
No, no. Not. Prof is good, he has Fox, he has Shine, he can't
get him. That re-grab was really sweet of the up tilt. Shit's happening. Attacks are being used.
Illusion.
Looking for the Shine Spikes. You don't have to look for the Shine Spikes anymore, Prof. Pro. He's at 108. One bear kills him. Wanted that one. I got hit by Firefox. Firebird. Oh.
That was a hard read. Boom! An up smash from Professor Pro.
Now he's going to go for the edge. Make Kaldew come to the edge. Center stage, actually. Not sure. Oh, he's here.
Shine. Some lasers. Back throw. And he waited.
Shine. That's what he wants, and he can do it again.
Exactly. It's not over.
Sense don't matter if you get flipped.
It's not over. He's still living. And now the tree wants some space.
Kaldew is gonna do the lot.
Now we are in the corner.
Going on. Not sure about going down into the chaos pit when you're.
Up throw, back air, and he's dead.
The bear kills him! And Kaldew is now up 2-0 against his pro.
It was close. Kaldew had, like, he played really well, like, in the beginning and in the middle of it, but in the end, Prof started, like, to recognize his move, like, he started to come back. But
same thing, probably the same thing that happened with Beaten Leffen, I would say, like, when the enemy's down to your last stock, you're like, it's just one stock. I don't have to.
There is something with that one stock is the hardest stock to.
The Nihonjin stock.
Precisely. That was like, goddamn. But he goes for Battlefield. Interesting choice. Close combat stuff.
Could finish this. Has stage control. Wants to make something happen.
Nice tech.
Two shines. Nice.
Nice by Kaldew.
That wave land off stage.
Really nice.
Trademark Kaldew. Copyright 2008-2014. Anyone who uses it may send $5 to Kaldew.
Nice facing, like he had a really good angle on his up B there.
Marco combos incoming. Nice stall.
Shine down there, forward smash. Gets the edge and gets down.
Doing
smash.
The style finish with the down smash.
Shine. Prof missed the back air, but. He gets up smash later on instead.
Space animals spacing?
Yep, they are spacing around, just waiting for the right moment to approach. The silence goes on when no one's doing anything.
Perfecto shield.
Okay, we're back. Forward smash. Yeah.
Kaldew going for the reverse fair, creating a combo video.
Nice up tilt. Back air, shine.
And you have the S Falco against Fox, you're dead.
Kaldew waiting. Want some. That was unfortunate.
It wasn't 105% though, so it's not that much.
It wasn't like the worst case scenario, but it still wasn't good. There's no. Suicide is never okay.
Dying is pretty worst case scenario, but it wasn't 105%. Professor Pro. Bringing in back. The back bringer.
Perhaps.
The bringer off back.
Really nice by Kaldew. Prof take it very carefully here.
We are now down to the last stock. What could be Professor Pro's last stock in this tournament? Both players looking to finish this.
Now, very patient game. Very, very. Take it easy, guys. Back air from the Kaldew. Profit on the. Gets the edge. Illusion. Back
that
air.
Hurts a lot.
He's still living.
I'm not sure if he's coming back.
And laser. Oh. Forward smash. And it's out. Kaldew takes it.
3-0 by Kaldew against the Pro Professor.
Rocky won against Hack.
Yes.
What does it look like? So now Rocky is up against Beats. So we will probably see Marth versus Captain Falcon.
Rocky Beat on stage, flexing muscles, drinking vodka.
Low legs. Okay.
Another combo heavy matchup. Captain Falcon can zero to death Marth, and Marth can zero to death Captain Falcon.
Like, both of them. Yeah, they can pretty much do the same thing, like. They.
However, Marth has. Once again, Marth has trouble on the lower percents.
Yeah.
It's gonna be mostly tech chase stuff when Captain Falcon is on lower percents, but when.
Yeah.
Once you get out of that tech chase stuff, you just go Yalex, 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 and then they're dead.
Yalex basically up tilt. But here we go on a battlefield.
Unlike Captain Falcon, who can just start comboing you right away.
Let's Marth see.
Combo food for Captain Falcon. The average Captain Falcon eats 5 Marths per day. So let's see how many Marths Rocky eats.
Viewer.
Rocky against. Rocky is now at least up at combo percent, so even if it looks like a lot of difference in the percent, it's not that much as.
And he gets the knee from.
However, yeah. He gets wrecked.
So yeah.
But 39 is a lot of percent. Those first few percent on Captain Falcon mean a lot, as now Marth has Captain Falcon on combo percent.
Nice one.
But through. Rocky is hungry for Marth.
Rocky plays a lot on the platforms, waiting. Gets the down air to knee. Let's see how much B can handle this. Down air.
Crowd screaming there as Rocky continues to eat Marth after
down
Marth.
Air. Weak knee, but it's still
teasing crowd with only using the
damn
weak knee.
Rocky plays real well here. Like, B has to focus now.
That's the combo!
Oh.
That would have been a kill.
You were an X smash.
No, it's deeper needed that. After that percent, you can't really combo with Marth anymore. It's really like, you don't want to go too high with Marth because then you can't combo into your finishers, so you are wrecked. He needed that forward smash and he got it, meaning we are still in the game.
Down throw, down tilt.
He could get this edge guard, but Rocky is so fast. Interrupting with Nair, nice. Beat has
down
managed
air
to slow down Rocky a bit, however, this is going to hurt a lot.
Yeah. Nice, nice. W-er.
No.
And yeah, Beat's dead. So, free stock to 1. We have seen it before. The last arc usually be the hardest one to take.
Rocky's gonna start going for Falcon Punch and Font.
Unfortunately.
Or just die.
Yeah.
Nah.
But yeah.
Rocky is a serious player. He's not gonna. I don't think he's gonna get that faced by Beat being down to his last stock, but we'll see.
Back there.
Working those percents. Beat just trying to get percents
nice
in any way he can so he can start comboing.
What is it? Forward, four throw.
We are now in combo percent, as can be seen by the spamming of the uppers.
Really nice.
Dance. The dance.
Morph dance.
We live in.
Oh, the
he misses.
He misses. Up throw.
That one doesn't though. Oh, he jumped out.
He missed that.
I have to remember that. That was at like 100%, I think. And Marth DI, he gets in charge. That was like at 100%, and Marth DI towards Captain Falcon, so he went straight up, and then he managed to jump out. Maybe Rocky was too slow, I don't know, but that was interesting. The Fountain of Themes.
The fountain that all dreams come true. You have just to believe it.
Yes. Beat chose this stage, right? Yeah. I feel like Fountain of Themes always like...
Yeah.
Some people are, oh, it's the best stage for Captain Falcon, and some people are, no, that stage sucks for Captain Falcon. And other people are like, oh, this stage should be good for Marth, and other people are like, oh, it sucks for Marth.
Yeah.
It feels like it's more of a player preference thing. Apparently, it's like Fountain of Themes. Currently in the lead.
WR, waiting for Beach recovery. But he's... With us one mistake, but he still... Yeah, he still get the kill. So yeah, Rocky, one stock ahead. Up throw. Down air.
Liking the down air on the platform, he wants more percent on Captain Falcon, so he can kill him. Now he is an edge guard, but Rocky is really good
knee
at spacing his
W. Back here. He gets a phantom hit, but like in the first.
He needs to finish this edge guard.
Yeah.
He gets it.
And
yes,
he will.
Captain Falcon can't really
nice
do much about that. That's the hitchbox of the
Ultra
Base
Base. That was unexpected.
Nice old school by Rocky, light shielding to wreck Marth.
Real life by Rocky, like, the knee came as a surprise for Beat and was like, he had no idea, he had no awareness that Rocky came from, like, just came with a knee. So
it's nice how, like, other games have the longer you combo, the less damage the moves do. In Smash, it's like the longer you combo, the more aware the enemy knows where to DI, so it won't be thrown as far by that reason. So if you manage to hit a knee like that randomly, then it's stronger.
Rocky needs to cancel. Beat punishes for him.
Forward smash from the forward throw. Nice there. Really good anti-air move.
And he gets a knee and Marth dead.
Sees the roll. Punishes the roll.
Some platform.
Rocky is spamming.
It is good in, like, in that position he was, it was good. But now Rocky has some problem. Beat gets the tipper, but Rocky survives down there.
Beat not getting the edge guards on Falcon, which is mostly because Rocky is good, I'd say.
Yeah.
You have to be tricky to get back against Marth with Captain Falcon. As your recovery is pretty predictable, and Marth is like the best game for the game. These sleep-offs by Rocky, man.
Yeah, yeah.
No room for punishment, only pain.
And he didn't
show me a game!
That was nice by Rocky, and it's 2-0.
Never nice to lose on your counterpick. Makes you question life.
And he goes to Fountain again.
Salty run back.
Salty run backs. I think it's a pretty... I like this stage. So... And I think Beats... Yeah. I think Beats are gonna be alright on this stage.
Sword dance is paying off.
And Beats takes the first stock.
Sucks when you just missed that. Because...
Down air.
Bam.
Knee.
Reverse knee. Or safe. Oh, nice dash behind my Marth. We are now at combo percent, ladies and gentlemen. This is Marth, up tilting.
Really hard to punish. Rocky wanted.
Nice. Should get this
he
edge guard.
The forward smash.
That was not nice to miss that, because
nice
now he might die before. No, he gets the nair. Should be an edge guard.
Forward air, missed the F smash. Gets a new chance.
Boom!
And takes it.
FBI?
FBI.
Nice. Oh, that's the first. You need those first percent. Now he can start doing stuff. Entering the realm of combos.
Nice. Shield dropping by. And the down smash was
almost.
Gets a nice
tipper.
Nice
Beat
tipper.
Is now controlling the game.
So, 3 stock 88%.
Rocky needed that.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me.
Sword dance? Down tilt?
Rocky really elusive, but gets hit by sword dance. Now?
Down air.
This is annoying. Like that Rocky is going for that. He probably would have killed Mark.
F tilt. You are.
Shield drop up air. Good shit.
Nice one by Rocky.
Marth always wants to hit you when he recovers. You just have to time your invulnerability frames. Sword dance working really well.
It's the air dodge instead of wave landing.
2-1 Rocky! Beat takes one game. Let's see where Rocky takes beat.
It's interesting. He had he counterpicks Dreamland. I was thinking about that. It's pretty hard.
I need to go away for like a minute, I'll be back.
Yeah. So at this stage, let's see. It usually be bad for Marth to not kill his opponent, but Beat has shown that this stage is really good for him. And yeah, that's... It's pretty dangerous to play against Beat on this stage. But yeah, some dance dances, gets a grab, up throw, up air, and he gets the knee after reading Beat. So, it's equal. It's even, basically. Yeah. Beat trying to pressure, Rocky gets a grab, down throw to upper, up throw, upper, down air, but Beat gets the dash attack, down tilt, and Captain Falcon finally gets him, down air to knee, and now he's out of stage. Rocky missed the edge, unfortunately. Let Beat came back, but it's okay, Rocky's still here. Beat punish, gets it, grab, down air, and he wanted to still come to that combo. Down throw, knee, and now this time Rocky will probably not make the same mistake twice. But instead, Lai Xin Ling, he gets in, and that was a close call. But he's, yeah, he got that. Beat, gets F smash, now edge guarding. I think, yeah. Down throw to up throw. Now Beat has some percent. Now he can start.
Right, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, what the fuck is going on?
What the fuck is going on? That Nair though. Captain Falcon is now at
up throw.
No up combo air, percent.
Down air to back air. Really good. And this is the problem. When once Marth cannot do a combo yes. set anymore. Then it's
we are in only. Land of Dreams, but FBI takes care of the job.
Yeah. So basically, once Marth cannot do a like 0-to-death stuff, he has a lot of problems afterwards to kill his opponent. So this could be Beat's last stock for this tournament.
If Beat can make something happen,
Nair.
Ally himself with FBI, put in surveillance in Greenland.
Really good. Yep, yep. It didn't pay off that good. Up throw.
He got the first percent on Captain Falcon, now he just wants to do a really smooth combo. Without getting grab, which is not what's happening right now, sadly.
Down air, knee.
This is... He's going for Falcon Punch.
No, he won't. And he's
going for the roll. And Rocky takes it.
Really good play by Rocky. Really good.
Beat not too proud, but Rocky is good at this game. Beat had his achievement in beating Professor Pro. Shame he couldn't get further.
So
now Kala W is up against
Rocky. I think this is for top 4, if I'm not mistaken it.
The curse of 4th from KLW, let's see if he makes it out this time. He really wants to. And Falco is arguably Captain Falcon's worst matchup.
Yeah.
Captain Falcon has a lot of troubles. He wants to be mobile, and Falco says no and lasers him. So it's like you either reflector shield lasers or you be pro. I don't know really. I don't play this matchup much. I just know that Captain Falcon has to work his ass off to get in on Falco.
Yeah.
But Rocky works out. So let's see if he can work in the game as well.
This is loser.
As we move into the first game on Battlefield.
Let's go. Play against the against each other on this tournament earlier.
Laser hits. Stop Captain Falcon. This is the tech chase that he wants to get.
Let's see.
You can say all you want about Falco's on stage game. When he's off stage, he's like, oh snap.
Up pro.
Not getting the reads right now, he needs them.
Nice play by Cal W.
Rough.
Gets a back
combo.
Air. Off the stage. Up pro. He's a little too lazy there, but. Too slow, basically. But yeah, Rocky made a mistake here now. Cal W has a lead.
I think going for that upper was the right decision. I mean that up B, because he was so high anyway, he needed to kill Falco.
Yeah. It didn't went out as he wanted it, basically. Yeah. So yeah. Rocky gets
getting
a lot of
started.
Hits.
Ah, misses the bear. Nice Falco kick. Rocky doing a good
and
job positioning himself in such a way that
nice power
lasers
by
don't
W.
count.
Forward B. Oh damn.
Do you agree that Rocky is doing a good job positioning himself in a way such that lasers don't really count? He's either above or below Falco or really close. So that Falco can't really use the lasers, which is his best tool in this matchup.
Nair. And yeah.
He was just hoping he would go down and punish. Or he missed the double jump. I don't know. Like, Falco is not getting any room to laser. He got it later, but not as much as he generally would. Rocky is handling the matchup really well.
Nice.
He's mostly moving up and down with Falco, so he's on top of him. So Falco has the room to laser. Looking really good.
Bear. Forward smash, a weak one, but.
Nice tech. He wanted to slip off and go down, but he just missed. Nice, he went
nice.
Below.
Back air.
Anyone's hit right now, gonna decide it. Both mess up. But
he wanted that back air, but he missed spacing it.
This hurt.
Yes,
yep.
This hurts. But it's pretty close, you can go either way.
Yes, Captain Falcon usually wants it now to get Falco off stage. He has no double jump. He wanted to punish that. KW dies with style. We are now down to last stock of first game. Just one grab!
It could be.
Let's see it happen. Let's see it happen. Rocky wants it. That would have hurt.
Rocky has a lot of
the
momentum.
Nice spot dodge from KW. Falco's tech is so fast, his tech roll. Really difficult to punish Captain Falco. He got it! And Rocky takes the first game instead of you. I think Cal W is gonna go for a bigger stage. Because he's not getting off in the lasers. Or a final destination where Captain Falcon has no platforms. This is gonna be really rough. Because
yeah.
Now he has no real way to dodge lasers. And I don't
nice
really
one.
See Captain Falcon winning on final destination.
Nice by Cal W.
Unfortunately, Mr. One. Back air. And F power forward smash.
I'm pretty certain Caladavio is gonna take this game. Because now Rocky has no way to dodge the lasers. However, Rocky with the big combos.
Yeah.
Threatening Caladavio.
Mind game stuff.
Caladavio trying to make a crowd laugh.
Back air.
That was close, but not quite.
Shine there.
However,
it's
there
not over.
Dumpster.
Falcon kick.
Falcon two.
And the Yevt kills him.
He needs something really big right now. He does not need the reverse punch.
A lot of shine pressure. Up tilt.
The thing is, like, he's getting love for shines now because he can't really. He has to be close to Falco, otherwise, he's just gonna get lasered and approach. He has no platforms now, so he can't stay at a distance like he could on Battlefield because then he could stay at a different height. He can't now, so he has to be close, and Falco is strong and he can't.
Forward B to F smash? Interesting.
So, really difficult time on this stage.
Yeah, it is.
Not. I don't think he's gonna get much more here. He had a really good combo going, and now he gets a fucking badass knee.
Yeps, yeps.
He could get something here.
Nice park, Rocky. Down air, gets a grab. It's pretty dangerous. Rocky's really good till once he gets a grab or something, he really makes the opponent to be scared of next move.
Yeah.
It's like
he's getting the combos now though, this could work.
Yeah.
Do you know that in NTSC, when Captain Falcon side B's, he goes behind Falco's lasers?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Does not impale. Rocky.
Rocky, aired on instead of wave one.
He did really good considering that was Final Destination. I thought he was gonna get like 3 stock because the entire game he played on Battlefield when he stayed on a different height.
I play with these guys like.
I like
really
this one.
Often. So they play super close. Almost no matter which kind of stage you play.
I guess he's really good at the matchup, man.
Yeah, we play a lot, the three of us. And some others as well.
But who plays Falco?
You. Who's?
You said the three of you play a lot.
Yeah, me, Caladavio, and Rocky.
Alright, so that's why he gets a lot of practice.
Yeah, we play real often with others from.
We're off to a rough start for our hero, Captain Falcon, who everyone loves. However, now.
And he gets
Caladavio expects another hit and the eyes for something else. Yes.
Yoshi's Story is interesting choice by Rocky, and overall, this is a small stage.
The knee! There!
Down air,
the knee.
Gets a knee, wants a down air, but
the push off.
The momentum, he that still had the momentum, but yeah, Caladavio, no worries, he got this, takes
well
the edge,
by
okay.
Covered okay. Everything. Rocky too fast. Do we cheat?
Now Caladavio gets some combos.
Randall action! Nipple spike into taunt.
Oh.
However.
And those taunts, shit. This is not a fight about who's going to lose the final. This is about who has like the pride. Hold down tilt, back air.
Rocky needs to get back on, he's back on. Very nice. He wants to get a grab now.
It's not
a
over
grab
until
or
it's
something
over.
That leads into a tech chase.
Viewer. Fair.
This is rough.
And a forward smash.
He was in a really rough spot. KLW takes the second game.
2-1.
Where do you go now? As Captain Falcon. I think the stage is good. I don't know if the stage was the problem. He might go back to
I
the same
don't
stage.
I think so, no?
Yeah, it did.
There's a like a small stage and you can't really edge guard Captain Falcon because there's like no space. So he, that's good for him, and also the stage is kind of small, so Fox and others, even if they would like to camp, Captain Falcon can always, you know, re-came from the other side of the stage, real close.
Yes.
Of the speed, and Rocky moves
normally.
Really fast.
Normally, Captain Falcon wants to run around a lot, but in this matchup, it's mostly about removing as much of Falco's laser game as possible, which is this game. However, now KW, Dubstreet.
He gets two stocks pretty early, so Rocky has a really.
Rocky needs to taunt. No, he needs to tech chase really well and get his reads like that. Hit.
Oh no!
I'm pretty sure he wanted to turn around. He saw that.
Color W. He wants to show that Cloudy is his teammates, no one else. Falcon kick. Rocky has to get the momentum back. It's like, it might look really hard and bad, but it's not impossible to bring it back. Back air. And you were real
that
nice.
That up air was really nice. Just reached. I didn't see it, what follow up he would use, and the upper used it.
Nah.
Teaching me how to play the game.
Shine. Shine.
Firebird. Not enough though. He might. Cal W takes it. 3-0 against Rocky. Absolut. Vill du byta här, Ryan?
Nej, jag kan hoppa av.
Jag kan hoppa av också, jag har suttit skit länge nu. However, I would like... Yes, please! Back
Yo,
to great stream. Commentary with randomness.
Yeah, hi guys. Okay, so we're in winners finals now, actually.
Yes.
Wow.
Approaching the end.
Not very unexpected turnout. Leffen versus Armada here. I don't know. Leffen closed out teams earlier today, tonight. I guess I should say. And I don't know. I mean, they played so well. So it's gonna be really exciting to see this winner's finals. And
is Armada going peach? It's my first.
He is. There's no reason that he shouldn't. He only plays Peach, basically, right now. So, and he beat him with Peach last time. So.
Oh yeah, I missed a few tournaments. My last tournament was the one where Leffen 6-0'd Armada.
Yeah. A lot has happened since then. Yes, basically, yes. The whole summer of Smash.
Yes.
And the most recent tournament being. Hit Stun 2 in Barcelona, Spain, where I don't think Leffen took a single game, maybe one, and then he lost to Ice, taking third place at that event. And now he's
people
here.
Get a lot of time to play in the summer.
Yeah.
So I think that's why you said earlier that Stoller said earlier that people have gotten a lot better in a short time.
Absolutely.
A lot of people have been like really
people
stepping
have been
up to that next level.
Stepping their game up. Okay, I think we're going right into it. Yeah, seems that way. Okay, we got Leffen with the Rage Fox versus Armada.
Well, this is the Armada we saw at Genesis 2. I am
this
hyped to see how that he's back.
Let's see what Leffen can do here. And in Loser's Final, Khaled W is waiting actually. So there's a lot of great Smash matches. Left.
Yes.
Leffen kind of struggling right now. He's trying to gain control. Like Armada keeps being in the center of the stage.
Yes.
While Leffen takes to the platforms. Like he tends to take to the platforms because he's getting outplayed in the neutral game, which you can see here. I mentioned earlier that like getting owned by any of these guys, it's not. Too bad since they're so good.
Yeah.
So like, but this like no one can make a pro look so scrubby like as another pro can do. So like that's what we're seeing here. Like Armada's combos are so ridiculous sometimes.
Yes.
But Leffen is still in it, and there is no sign of him letting up. Wow, he actually
that
gets that
nice.
One.
That was nice.
Really nice. Leffen is not giving up.
That's what you want against Peach. You want your shine stuff, and you want your after.
Yeah.
Basically, your bread and butter Fox stuff.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Swedish sniper. making an appearance.
Oh, nice grab by left hand.
Now Armada
smashed eyeing like. Smashed the eyeing like crazy person right now. Oh, is he gonna get that one? Left hand struggling to regain control. Nice grab by left hand. I think Levin really wants to prove himself. Like, after the loss in Barcelona, he has been really sad, or like he was kind of down.
First game.
I think he really wants to prove his worth, like that he's no, that he is the, like at least the second best in Europe, which in my opinion he still is, even though he lost to Iceland. Okay, Armada closing out first game. Levin going to Pokémon Stadium here in the winners finals.
Pretty clear counterpick for
yeah,
Fox again.
Yeah, like a conventional and like conventional counterpick, and there's a reason for that. Like
yes,
Fox's neutral game is so good at this stage, and like it's got a lot of
the stage
combo
has everything you want.
It
as
does.
A Fox player.
Exactly. Oh, Armada getting first.
Armada does
match.
Not care about that though.
Oh, first
the combos.
Yeah. Armada sometimes says that. For Peach in this matchup, both in singles and in teams, it's like sometimes he says it's unwinnable, sometimes he says it's just really hard. and I really feel for him.
I'd say that depends on what game he played last and how it went.
Yeah, exactly. But that's usually what he says. But he isn't giving Levin any quarter here. Like he does not seem to be bothered by the stage at all, to be honest.
The stage can only help you so much.
Exactly. But Leffen's still doing a great job. Phenomenal Fox player from
yes.
East Coast Sweden. Oh, nice take by Leffen.
The recycle.
Oh my
attack.
God. Is that gonna be it? Wow.
So many options covered by that turnip. He was basically
yeah.
forced to decide being in there. And I was like, yep. That's where you go.
These two have like a really rich history.
Yeah, yes.
Like, they've been like first and second in Sweden for a long time.
Yes.
And like before the summer of Smash, Leffen was like pretty dominant actually.
Yes.
But Armada's got it back since he.
Which I am happy to see, and
yeah.
which is what Leffen said after 6-0ing him. He said, "I hope this makes Armada practice more."
Yeah,
which
so
apparently he's done.
Yeah,
because now he's in the lead.
So yeah, I think this is good for both of them. Like they have to help each other improve by improving. I guess.
Going for bear instead of upper as Armada has been smash dying.
Oh my God, Leffen.
Damage.
Oh, nice power shield. Leffen, like he tends to be a lot more defensive now, like in the later half of the game. We'll see how that's gonna turn out. Like he's lasering a lot because he knows that being too aggressive will only result in him getting dash attacked.
Yes, he's switching up mid game. You have to try new stuff.
Exactly. He tried to adapt. Wow.
That,
wow,
up
that up smash was
he's slowing
incredible.
Climbing back when he's playing defensive. I think Leffen is about he's finding something here.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. Oh, is that gonna be
this
it?
This is rough though. Swedish sniper making
oh,
an appearance.
Oh, he misses that recovery. Okay.
To Armada.
Winners finals here at Beauty 8 with me, Randomness, and Arky on commentary.
Yes.
2-0 Armada versus Leffen.
However, it
third
looked,
game.
Looked like Leffen. Yeah, he's going back to the conference.
It looks
stadium.
Like he
was
onto something.
Yeah, he was slowly
he was
climbing
onto something
back.
Last game. Absolutely.
And right now he is in the lead, but Armada
oh,
is
oh, you can see him kinda you can see that he was disappointed by that. Which is understandable. Great back here from the
that shine must have been really close. Parasol combos. Nice smash die.
It's important for Leffen not to get flustered right now, like with him suiciding, like self-destructing first stock.
Yes.
He has to forget about that and just get back into it, which we see him do here. Like he doesn't seem too bothered, even though he's down.
It's so difficult to finish people off when they smash the upper type sense pods.
Yeah.
It feels like you have nothing when they start doing that. Like,
yeah,
I can't.
But the thing is that Fox is one of those characters that got so many options.
Yes.
So like a lot of Fox players tend to tunnel vision, but like, I need to get the up throw up air. But that's not true. Like, you can do a lot of other stuff as well. But I get like you get the feeling of being locked down.
Yes.
And as I say that, Armada closes up the second stock left hand.
You know,
in this potentially last game of Winners Finals. Oh my god, Armada.
Going for the platform.
Wow,
Armada reacting slightly faster.
Let's see what Leffy. Yeah, now he's on the defensive again. I think that's gonna benefit him.
Yeah?
If he just takes it easy. Like, no one ever, like, power shields or cares too much about the lasers.
Oh!
Nice by Leffen.
A slight bait going away and then going back in with an up.
Even though he's, like, losing the neutral game, he's still, like, holding it, keeping it kind of close. Amazing edge guard, as usual, by Armada. But never, you should never count Leffen out, especially on this stage.
That's
and
nice
with this
combo.
Character. Let's see what he can do here. Oh my
this
god!
This is Leffen. A lot of percent very fast
yeah.
from Leffen.
But
he's
gonna get flustered if he gets too damaged here. So,
now it's looking rough.
Nice recovery by Leffen, like. Armada really tried to trap him down.
You know Armada is good at edge guarding when.
Oh, 3-0 for Armada.
That's the same. You know Armada is good at edge guarding when you say nice recovery means only taking 30% damage before you're making it back on the stage. Then Armada is good at edge guarding.
Kalle! No.
Kalle,
this is something I've been wanting to see for a long time, actually.
They haven't met during the summer.
No, they haven't. I don't think they've. They don't. They haven't played for a long time.
KW is new, at least third, right?
Yeah, this is loser final.
So
yes.
He broke the fourth court curse.
No, but that was not in singles. Only team. That was a teams thing. About him always getting fourth in teams. Okay.
Anything
going
in
right
particular you want to see? You just want to see how it plays out.
Yeah, okay. So game one of Losers Finals.
Yes.
Kalle W. Shaft Kalle W. versus Leffen. I know that this is like me and Kalle W. I don't like most people who know him and know me, like they know we're great friends. So like this is a match that Kalle W. has been wanting to play for a long time. This is a long time coming. And yeah, we're good. This is. I'm really excited. So Leffen's up one stock, but the great thing, like, Kalle doesn't seem bothered at all. Like he's just kind of trying to slow the match down to his pace. I'm not by any means saying that he's slow because he's not, but like in this matchup. You kind of want to slow the Fox down.
Yes.
So he doesn't get too
yeah,
crazy.
Yeah, Fox runs faster than you, he shuffles faster.
Yeah.
Falco is fast, but not as fast as
exactly.
Fox.
Exactly. Oh. Ho ho! He gets the Zlatan, as it's called here in Europe and in. Well, mainly Sweden, I guess.
Kadav, you're looking for an in to get first shine.
Oh,
that grab would have been
yeah,
a lot
not,
of damage.
He's not greedy, like, he really tries to. Oh my god, the recovery. What is Leffen doing?
He positioned his up so that if Leffen would have let go, he would have just grabbed the edge. So.
Ah, I just killed him.
Oh. manages to make it back despite being in up B position as Falco.
Yeah.
Twice.
Falco being the famous glass cannon of this game. He can blow you up, but he also blows up really easily.
Yes. I said before in the previous game, if you up B as Falco against Fox, you're dead.
Well, yeah.
Most of the time.
Yeah, it's you should be dead if the Fox is of this caliber.
He's made it back twice. Tricky up B.
Yeah.
Oh.
The fair?
Oh, that's
making
that,
it happen.
That should be it.
Making it work. Like, you see, there's already passed like
this is damage.
3 minutes. KaliW is really trying to slow the pace down of the game, which is working out. Like, it's kind of working out. We're seeing him do it.
Up tilt just a tad too early. We've had a lot of percent. See if we can make. Left runs around and bears him.
KaliW on his last leg, the last stock of the first game of Losers Finals. Let's see if he can kill Leffen here. And Leffen is also like, he's playing really respectful, like he's not doing a lot of stupid stuff and just going ham. Like he really respects the way Kali is playing right now. Oh, Kali wanted the platform there too.
Yeah.
To get some jump thing going.
Would have had a punish on Fox. I mean, a finish.
Is that gonna be it? That's it for the first.
He had to go for a quote unquote weird recovery to make it back.
For some of you, I'm gonna sound like a broken record. For others, I'm not. So, for the all the new viewers, this is Beauty 8, Gothenburg, Sweden, with me, Randomness, and Arky on commentary. Losers Finals, KaliW versus Leffen,
which is now 1-0.
Yeah, we just saw Leffen closing it out. What do you think? What like in your opinion, what would you say that Kala has to do to close this one out? What do you think he needs to do differently?
He is now on Fountain of Dreams, which means that the ceiling is higher and the walls are closer. So he wants to. He got chance back. He wants to combo into spot again.
Yeah, he's known for his forward smashes, and right as I say that,
yes,
it's actually his nickname in Swedish, too, like Sparken, which means the kick. So
it sounds so silly, really.
Yeah, it does. But well, Mini Sparken is his, because Sparken is a Sia Kalistan, but. Oh my god,
that he knew about that percent.
Yeah.
He just felt it.
He tends to go for that kind of often, with great success in most cases, like the down tilt. Which is not a very conventional choice, but like it works out. It's a really strong fast move.
Yes.
But you have to kinda like either shield poke or
exactly. This is gonna hurt.
Oh.
No, it didn't.
Wow,
or does it?
Great DI.
Fountain of Dreams!
Fountain of Dreams and great DI.
Yes.
Okay. It's gonna be it for Kala's third star.
He needs some nice combos now.
Oh, the Shangri-La. Bam! Well,
he can do that again. If he does, it's an even game.
I'm not gonna be biased, but the crowd is biased, and they're cheering for KaliW. So we're in the west coast of Sweden right now, and KaliW is one of the strongest players in this region.
Yes.
So it's no surprise that people are cheering.
Playing
for him,
on home ground, left and visiting
home field,
home field.
Oh, great little kick. Okay, wow, last stock for
if
both Falco
players. Gets a nice combo going now, it's gonna be even game.
Yeah, like 55% is nothing, basically. It's basically nothing. Well, it is 55%.
However, 85% is rough, because now he can get
now
up throw bared.
He can get forward smashed if he doesn't DI properly. That's gonna be it.
That's it. He didn't have a jump.
Okay, so it's 2-0 Leffen versus shaft Cali W.
Fountain of Dreams didn't work. Do you think he's going to blame the stage and move on, or blame himself and go back?
The thing is that I think he wants to go for like either Josh's story or Pokemon Stadium. But I think if he goes to Pokemon Stadium, he is afraid that he's gonna get foxed, basically. So he goes back.
He feels it's a good stage and he wants to go back to. Wants to go back to Fountain of Dreams. I'd say it's the best stage for Falco, just because Falco likes to kill off the side and Fox likes to kill off the ceiling.
Exactly. And you also have to take like
this up tilt! Playing for the crowd. Working. Oh, he got to the ledge. I think left and smashed the eye laser, but I'm not sure.
Like, when choosing a counter pick, you have to have other stuff in consideration as well. Like, not only your... Like, there's also an element of, like, what you prefer, like, personal preference.
Yes.
And I know that Kalw obviously is good at this stage, so... Great choice. For both him and the character.
Yes.
He actually takes first stock. Is that a first for this set?
Yes, it is.
I think
it's
it is.
First time.
And he did it in a kind of a dominant way too, like.
Yeah.
And right as I say that, Leffy takes his stock.
This is a mistake, but he makes it back.
Oh. Come on. Oh my god.
Speaking of the unconventional choice of the down tilt.
Yeah, they're actually using it to combo to the down air. As an edge guard. Oh my
god.
He
took his rings. Yeah. No jump. Rough.
Oh,
that kick,
that
though.
Kick, yeah. Kalw is like a Matt.Seb, but good. Sorry, Matt.Seb, if you're watching. No, I'm just kidding.
That
oh,
fast.
Oh.
Oh, he missed the last one, but that was really nice.
Oh, he wanted to go for the down smash there, yes. I guess. I'm guessing.
Yeah, he positioned himself for Hellsman.
Yeah. This game is so close. I think it's cool to see that Cali is really showing that he can hang with the best here, with the top.
Yes. Like. Crowd cheering for Kalw.
Is he gonna make it? Shoot. Oh. He was in range, but he got mind game. Oh my god.
Nice get up attack.
See if he can take this game. Oh, left hand going in right now.
Damage.
Oh, these
no platforms
tech chases
on the sides.
Are rough. Kalw. Is he gonna make it back or is this gonna be it for you?
Ah, he made it back.
He made it back.
Yes. Oh. Just needs one hit now to get something started.
Yes, but he also has to be really careful. He can't really trade here, so
no.
Like the space is being impeccable, which it's not.
Fast bear down.
3-0 for Leffen versus Kalw. And now I'm gonna drop off.
Alright.
Nice commentating with you, man.
Nice commentating
and
with
good luck
random
to both
names.
Players. I hope my commentary isn't too bad.
Mine sucks, but I don't care.
Okay, so enjoy this grand finals between Leffen and Armada. Bye, stream.
I'm going to do my best to keep you updated on what's happening on the screen in the Grand Finals. We are starting right away. Rivals now facing off. Armada, with his basic combos, knows how to handle Fox, takes first stock. Leffen falling back into defensive position, which paid off last game. He's now in control, might take a stock back from Armada without taking any percentage himself. Making the aim here. Really patient recovery. It seems I am joined by the one and only Mike Hagar.
Yes, now I am here. What's up again, guys? And we got Grand Finals, and you saw a really nice, really fun set between Leffen and Kalw. just now, but now we got the grand finals. Last time it was a 3-0, but Leffen has beaten Armada at Republic of Fighters and at Beast 4.
Yes.
So he's taken, he hasn't just beaten him once, taking an entire tournament over him, but twice. And all in all, that's four sets. So,
yes.
I mean, this is...
When me and Randomness was commentating on the last set, we saw that whenever Leffen goes on the offensive, it doesn't really pay off. But when he falls back more and tries to like react to Armada's play, it works better for him. So
yes, he actually said earlier that he...
Oh, that was just...
Yeah, that kind of sucks. He actually said earlier that he's trying to start to play more aggressive because he believes it to be better to be able to at least vary your playstyle. I'm not sure if he said that he believes aggressive Fox to be better or not, but he wants to learn to play more aggressively. But this is Grand Finals, and there's no doubt he's going to do everything to win.
Yes.
There's prize money on the line, there's even more pride on the line.
Both players looking to take this no matter
what
they have to do in-game.
And... Det är helt tillsynkat ljudet. Kan vi få spelljud här som är synkat där på något sätt? För det är helt osynkat. Okej, ja, Leffen.
Ja, Leffen suicide.
Ja, men... Okej.
Man vänder sig faktiskt när man inte bryr sig så mycket om det. Discussing how the audio is not synced for us watching the game.
Yeah, we need AGP for streaming. Yeah, and that last match could have... I mean... If it wasn't for those unfortunate SDs, it would have been close. And now it's Pokemon Stadium. Double jab. Wow, nice spacing. Just standing there with the down tilt.
Working out.
It's really... Smash is really... It's an interesting game as far as hitboxes go. Because the hitboxes are in 3D as opposed to 2D like most fighting games. It becomes more variables decide what hitbox wins over another. And spacing... Like small millimeters will make a difference.
Armada being really on point when he's snare game off stage now. I think he hasn't dropped a single one.
No.
Yeah. All the up B's, all the side B's, snare. Spinning around.
Yeah, it's I've seen it so many times getting hit in my face with it, so I'm kind of okay. And an upper just got the second hit, that's really good.
Well done. Armada's been so on point smash during the upairs.
Yeah. Yeah, you have to do that. That's the next step. They start smash DI-ing. What do you do? Do you start complaining or do you adapt? You adapt.
You adapt.
And now we got these transformations. Fox has an advantage here. If you get into the little Fox hole, even though percentages can decide, if you're down by percent, it can be worth attacking Fox down there.
Yeah. Parasoling his way out, nice choice. You don't want to be down there with Fox.
Yeah, and it's also Peach's fastest option, auto shield.
Yes. These snares, man.
Yeah, that's some really good timing, and the hitbox is there on the up B. They turn on and off, on and off, on and off quickly. So you have to for the fire to not hit you first, or for the for it to not even trade. That takes some really good timing and spacing.
Yeah.
It's Armada may make Peach look easy, but try it for yourself and you notice there are quite a few little things that you're barely aware of that make a huge difference.
Yes.
Oh wow.
Nice escape from that pressure. And Swedish Sniper not here this time.
And wow, nice.
Swedish Sniper makes an appearance.
Yep.
Jumping over the
Catching that low forward B. Oh wow, a big damage from the down smash
that
doesn't convert
really
into
nice
anything. And he goes for that. Armada does that a lot after double jabs. He go people often jump, and Armada goes for full jump up air, and people jump into it. But Leffen outspaced him, and he started doing that at Beast actually. With he did fade back nares, full jump fade back nares, and the one player that. The transformation don't mess with as much as Armada. He was able to adapt to that. And he misses it. Leffen misses the L Council, but it didn't matter because Armada expected him to get the L Council, so he didn't go for a grab. This is super close, but that's super strong there.
Need a sniper?
Yeah.
Makes an appearance.
He should. He was going for an air with that fair for sure. That was just a misclick. And can Leffen take this game?
Armada living.
Armada makes an amazing recovery. Oh.
Close. 1-1.
1-1. Uses that up tilt. Leffen uses that a lot versus when Armada is coming in. A lot of foxes get really antsy and just want to hit Peach with that up smash. But the thing is, if Peach can air dodge through the up smash and punish, but if Fox does an up tilt instead and Peach,
it's like the more
that,
safe option.
Yeah, it's the more safe option.
And it kills early.
It kills early.
Yeah.
It's really like in Pally. It's not. It's barely. It's not that big of a difference. That's for the grounded hit. There's actually two hits for the Fox's up tilt. You have a grounded hit as well that has more knockback. And
don't face. Nope.
And with that huge back air, it's something that Armada has implemented in his playstyle more and more as 20xx is approaching. Really, he's not using as many just floating around going for fares as much as he used to. People wait him out these days.
Yeah.
People have adapted, and he goes for the back air, which has a massive hitbox. And Armada...
Yeah, like that.
Yeah. It beats so much. It's really like... You have to. It's important advice for new players to really explore the hitboxes, because a lot of the times, something that you don't expect to win will win.
Yes.
Like.
I think Jigglypuff's bear is the best example.
Yeah.
It looks like she just pulls out a little feet, but then you look at the hitbox.
Yeah,
and
and it's massive.
To the other side of the stage.
Exactly, and the Z-axis, since the hitboxes are in 3D, even the Z-axis decides priority slightly. Okay, and
Leffen not getting any percent in this stock. Armada.
Yeah, but he's doing what he should right now. He's camping and just trying to build up a little bit of percent. Make Armada approach you. Make Armada pissed off that you're just camping all the time, and capitalize on that mistake. But don't be don't try too much to capitalize on the mistake.
It's working real well.
He's
got
yes.
90% from just chilling.
Yes, exactly. He hasn't. Not a single combo. It's been lasers and bears. He's not taking any risks. He's abusing the lack of approach options for the lack of good approaches versus this fast fox.
And the large stage.
Yes. Absolutely that. This is actually, a lot of people consider this stage really good in this matchup for Fox, for the simple reason that Fox can camp. And this seems to be go along with what we said before, that Leffen is doing better when he's playing more defensive. And now he's definitely playing more defensive this match. And
if it keeps going, I think Armada is going to switch to smaller stages because he sees that
whenever
Fox is off reach.
Yes, and that might actually be one of the reasons why Leffen wants to learn to play aggressive. To make people... To save his camping, basically, so people keep counterpicking big stages.
Down tilt, making an appearance again. Working.
Yeah, that move is really good. It's randomly really good.
Yep. That was really fast back on stage by Leffen.
Yeah.
Caught Armada off guard.
And now, yeah, this can decide so much. This stock right here.
Yes.
Because if Armada dies first, I think we're gonna see the same kind of gameplay from Leffen that we saw the last time Armada was up an entire
when
stock.
When he got 90% thrust hit.
Shield drop and a missed up smash.
Leffen
doesn't get the grab. Yeah, there he did something uncharacteristic and got antsy for the up smash. Yeah, but Leffen gets the kill now, and that was super important, and Leffen jumped into that. Leffen jumped
Swedish
into
sniper
that.
Sniper.
Yeah.
Stepping in.
Yeah, he was completely dead after the nair because he had used his double jump. There was nothing he could do.
Yeah. Pressuring Leffen to the edge of the stage. Leffen coming back in. Oh, not really.
Dash attack, that hurts. Oh.
Did he miss float?
I think so. I think we're seeing a little bit of chokesies here. And the fourth.
That's how you know it's grand finals. You have to have some.
Yeah, even Armada has feelings.
2-1 for Armada.
Yep. A brought Sturupta.
I missed it like 3 times in a row, and they were like, "What are you doing?" And he missed it. I'm like, "Okay, I'm gonna go."
Yeah, that's a good thing. I should start doing that.
2-1 for Armada, as we go to a smaller stage. No, this is Leftos counterpick.
Yes. So I'm guessing he's looking to change up his strategy quite simply. This has to be it. I mean, he can't camp on the stage, but he can kill Pete.
Leftos
leader
likes this stage though. He likes to like shore up and wave land on platforms.
Oh yeah, you can get up on the like side platforms from the edge and be completely invincible. Fox,
it's really sick.
Yeah, just land there and shield, and like who the hell can do something about it?
No one.
Yeah, Bowser has an air grab. Not that it's very relevant, but... Oh, nice back air. That's another typical Armada mix-up. He goes for that low float back air on the shield, and he mixes up between down smash and... down smash and another full jump air.
Tricky place to be in with Fox to up air. To up throw, you're not gonna get anything.
Yeah.
I like the down throw when you're on platforms, just because there's like no room to tech.
Yeah, there's no room to tech, it's much easier to react. It's actually, it's a really good option for the most part, to just go for the down throw there. I remember Zero clutch out a match versus Armada that way, with a down throw up smash in just that situation. And a back air, it's a trade this time, but that trade did not matter a whole lot for Armada. Armada covering a lot of space. Not letting Leffen go anywhere on this small stage.
Being up 3 stocks against 2. Fox needs to pull out some nice combos here to make it back.
Yeah.
Or lasers.
Yeah.
Not as easy on this stage though, as it's smaller.
Yeah. Oh, nice punish. Wow, he didn't go for the... Actually, it was... Probably better for the brother, it was smart.
That was close. I think that up smash would have killed, I'm not sure.
Yeah, but Armada got the shield up. You can't do like... Actually, not in that situation he could. It depends on how many hits hit you. And Armada doing his classic float fair game.
A lot of up smashes from Leffen.
Yeah, okay, great DI by Leffen there. DIing behind Armada. And Armada hits a... shield bottom. Leffen camping by the edge. Perfectly converts a turnip into a snare.
Yes. It's best out of 5, right?
Yes.
And Leffen is in losers, so this
could be the last match of this entire tournament, I believe.
That
very
was
nice.
Really slick.
Yeah, that was very nice. People forget that option. It's just taking the edge.
You just take.
Just take it. When people camp the edge, just take it.
Leffen tried to force his way, and Armada punished.
Yeah.
Damage.
Wow.
He dies from another up throw, up air.
Yeah.
If he misses the smash DI.
Yeah.
That's really.
And
now
edge guarding can also be like. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Damn. Oh, yeah. He tried to go for down smash there after, and he gets the hedgehog.
Okay. All right. Leffen might make a comeback here.
Yeah, definitely could. He just needs a combo or... Yeah, he can't play like he did on Dreamland this time. He's gonna need some sort of combo. Or an edge guard. It's hard on Peach, but if you trick Peach into going low, then you can definitely do it. And very nice by Leffen reactively rolling away. And a stitch face! And Armada takes it with a stitch face in the situation when it didn't matter.
Yeah. And the turnip would have killed.
Yeah.
Swedish sniper, headshot, skill shot.
Yep. Oh, good stuff, Armada.
That's the tournament.
That's the tournament.
Big place, easy rares, easy life. I had fun commentating. I had no idea if I had any sort of quality, but it was fun.
Hur mycket viewers ligger vi på?
Hur mycket vivers?
Hehehehe.
Yeah, well, I'm happy to see Amala playing Peach again, since I haven't watched any like Smash in the summer, so I'm happy to see that Amala is back to
Yeah,
Peach.
Me too. Yeah, we can absolutely do an interview. We'll do Thorin.
I don't know. You do it. I'm new to commentating, so if you want to make me do an interview as well, I'm gonna be like, so
yeah, okay,
you
play
Peach?
Yeah, all right. Yeah, but you did a good job.
Thank you. Yeah. I'm gonna watch it. Commentating is fun.
Yeah, it is. Okay, but so we're gonna have a short interview with Armada.
Yes.
The two drunk buddies here. Again, back on Armada's stream.
I'm going to give Armada a hug and pass over the headset.
Yeah, it's not coffee here. It's just like gin. 99%. 80%.
Fun, big place. The Kudo City goes to the pitch. I got it. Stick, stick, stick. Bra spelat. Man
Yeah. Oh well, congrats Armada.
Thank you.
So yeah, you played. This was quite a big tournament with quite a lot of upsets in it.
Yeah, for sure.
There were a lot of things, but let's talk about that later. Let's say, so you had, what bracket did you have? You met Kelly W.
Yeah, I met Kelly W. Eagle, Air Rider. And it was someone in between Air Rider and Eagle. I can't quite remember now.
Whatever, but you blazed through this tournament pretty hard. And even though Kelly W put on quite a show, he didn't come quite as close as we all hoped in the crowd.
Yeah, he usually takes a game.
Yeah, he usually does, actually. So, and it was really like me and a few other Smashers said that you haven't been to a Swedish tournament if you haven't seen this set.
Yeah,
like it has to be.
Happens. Yeah, like grand finals for like 2-3 years or something like that.
Yeah, exactly. And now, how did you feel versus Leffen? Now things have changed quite a bit. I mean, it went from you getting 6-0'd in Fox Dittos from 3-0 to 6-0, and also at Beast, he really made the Fox Peach matchup look quite hopeless. It felt like he had figured some stuff out that just like all of your old tricks didn't work.
Yeah.
But what do you think has changed?
I think when we played at Beast, it was more like, maybe it was the fact that I hadn't been playing for so long, so I fell into old habits easier, you know?
Oh yeah.
I think like my shape at Beast wasn't that bad. Like yeah. Playing with ice before a tournament, I still felt like I could do most of my stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Obviously some of them were worse, but I think it was more like I went for the same kind of tactics and tricks over and over. And Leffen had been doing his homework, so every time I was going for, you know, one thing or another, he already knew it, and then he destroyed me for it.
Oh, yeah.
And now, like, after playing in America for so long, and so many different people, styles, and see what works here, what works there, I think I've started to become better at changing, you know, my style mid-game.
Mixing it up. But that's something, actually, when I go between changing, you know, playing different players all the time, it can actually make you have more habits in a sense, because the same old tricks will keep working because it's new people every single time. How do you avoid that?
I guess I don't try to, you know, overestimate how good something is. Just because it works against one player, it might not work against someone else. Like, I usually say Smash is sort of like a fast-paced rock, paper, scissor.
Yeah.
And obviously, if your opponent is always going to play rock, then paper is going to work for you.
Yeah.
But the next person might play completely different. And I feel like, especially with like Fox, you can play in so many different ways.
Yeah.
So I'm really, really trying, you know, to mix it up and understand, you know, the emotion of my opponent and, you know, like finding, you know, patterns and habits. So it's a tricky game for sure, but
yeah.
I think I'm getting there, you know?
Yeah. Okay, nu har vi ljud här. Nu har vi spelljud. Va?
Kag.
Let's continue with the interview like this, because game sound game. But, so you ran this tournament as well, but this was a way smaller tournament than so
yeah,
quite a bit easier.
But yeah, it was still some work to do, obviously.
Yeah.
And every now and then I want to check the stream and
you know, make sure people are playing the matches, reporting matches.
Yeah.
We do have quite some work to do here in
Europe. Yeah, I think so. That's the area where we're the furthest behind. We're lazy.
Yeah, we are way too lazy. Yeah, being in America for, you know, 2 months, as a TO, it makes me realize even more that the entire mentality around the tournaments needs to change.
Yeah, I think it's because our scene has been smaller for so long in Europe that we're used to having these kinds of tournaments with maybe 30 people, and then there's no hurry. Like,
you
really can go outside for a walk between sets. You can't do that when the tournaments are bigger. So we really need to change and get used to that. But what did you think about the other players here at this tournament? There were some upsets that happened. Rocky had quite a showing. Rax beat Hack.
Yeah, Rax.
Which was by far the biggest upset.
Yeah,
like, Hack.
Rax and Yurk was probably the two players that impressed me the most.
Yeah.
Like, in terms of, like, how most people would look at these players before the tournament and after.
Yeah.
It's very, very huge.
Yeah.
And overall, I think, like, maybe Sweden is finally underway, you know?
Yeah.
I felt like it was a lot of people doing great this tournament. Like,
yeah.
I'm a bit sad for Android. Like, he had, you know, a very, very consistent, you know, records and, you know, placements. So it was a bit disappointing for him, but I know he will be back stronger. And some days, you know, it's Smash.
It's super hard to be consistent in this game.
But to be fair, though, like, it was two great players. We saw Beat almost taking two games of Leffen.
Yes.
So that's very, very fun.
Yeah, that really is. It's this country isn't just you and Leffen.
Yeah.
It certainly isn't.
The thing is, like, for placements, average placement is, like, very important. And I will still probably put Andre as third, but it's so many, many players right behind now.
Yeah.
Rocky, Color W, and Beat. Especially those three.
Yeah, I absolutely agree with that.
Yeah, but we saw Dev in Finland at Comeback. He was beating
Dev as well. Dev, and I think Hack is kind of, with the exception of him losing to Rax, which, like, you have to get through your head, like, how random this is. Or not random, I mean, Rax was amazing, but, like, Hack used to be one of the very best. He's been top three in Sweden, right?
I think not a real top three, but slightly behind, like, 4th, 5th.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think
okay.
It was me, Cal W, and IVP back then.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
then
that
he was arguably number 4.
Yeah, but that's how it was when I joined the scene, actually.
Yeah,
that's
and
that
then
was the ranking.
Then when IVP started to, you know, step down a little bit.
Yeah.
Leffen started to improve even more.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's.
Yeah, so
I hope we can continue, you know, to improve, because a lot of these areas in Sweden have, like, weeklies now.
Yeah, everywhere, and I'm first really feeling like I got a reminder this tournament that in order to be good, you have to practice, like,
yeah.
And you gotta think of it like a job almost. With some things you kind of do, and
yeah.
You gotta think like just as with a real job, the reward comes later. That feeling you get when you win a hard set.
It's
worth it.
So
it's
good.
Worth all of those hours. Believe me, guys. It's worth it.
But yeah, maybe we should have some questions from the stream chat.
Oh, yeah.
Rocky, can you check the chat? Any questions in particular you guys want to ask? But yeah, has been a great weekend. A bit stressful, though. And I'll be happy to go back tomorrow after all the cleaning, of course.
Yeah, I'm gonna vote tomorrow.
Yeah, I should vote as well.
Yeah, you really should.
The thing is, when do they close?
I don't know.
And I
was planning to do it in the morning.
Yeah, in the morning I will still be here. The American tournaments I plan attending in a soon future or in close future is Big House, Shape 5, Justice. And then it's one tournament in between Shape and Big House, but I can't really remember the name right now. But these four, then Apex, obviously. And then, you never know, maybe something else.
Yeah, we'll see. And hopefully I will come to America someday.
As I said, for a long time.
You said for so long time. Yeah. Like when I decided to retire back in 2013, like, oh, I never got the chance, you know, traveling with you to America.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And now I have the chance again.
Here I am, dude.
Yeah, I know. I know. But I have too little money. I should get a job.
Yeah.
So I get money.
Yeah.
I'm pretty poor as it is, and I'm bad at like organizing money, but jag ska ställa frågan så strunt. How do you deal with aggressive players first of all? That seems to be less of a problem for you.
Yeah, I actually like aggressive players. Like, the thing is, I don't really mind campy players these days anyway, but the thing is, when someone is playing aggressive, a lot of them, somehow, at some point, they are gonna lose their patience. And guys, like, I'm taking it wrong, sorry. But the thing is, like, when they are playing aggressive, I think it's a bit more, you know, important, you know, to stay yourself calm, think about your decisions. The thing is, like, the mentality of like PC Chris, for example, it was like, if you put enough pressure on someone, eventually they crack down.
Oh yeah.
And I think it's very, very important to, like, you know, if you feel like it's very hard, very, you know, in your face all the time, maybe the tech skill is not on point between the stocks. If you lose a stock, just stay on the platform, you know, for a while.
Yeah.
Because these aggressive players, they want to go in. They don't usually like to wait.
Oh yeah, that is true.
And I'll tell you guys, I played against Hungerbox. I can wait for days.
I don't want to see that again. That was, it was fun the first time, but after that it was just like...
Yeah, it was so fun the first time, but after that, no.
Okej, vad var den andra frågan? Yeah, how much do you think Professor Pro has improved?
He has improved a bit. The thing is, he arrived at Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday. And then on Wednesday, we were both pretty tired. I was streaming for a long while. And he arrived super early in the morning, so he didn't sleep the night before. So I've only played like one and a half day, sort of.
Yeah.
But the thing is, he's gonna stay until Monday night. So I hope, you know, he's gonna learn even more, and for myself too, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So, and I should come by and play with you guys. Maybe we can stream some more.
Yeah.
I would like to play.
Actually, we plan to play PM Sunday and Monday. Which
I would love to come by and play. And if Gusti, the Lucas player that you saw putting in a lot of work here on the stream, he could perhaps come by as well.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I would love for it.
Yeah.
But yeah, me and Prav is gonna team at Big House for PM. And
yeah, but you lost Android and Senkai. That was one big upset that we forgot about.
Yep, that was huge. We lost against
them. And
him.
Me and my teammate, we beat Android and Senkai.
Yeah.
So that means
and
we're
they
better.
Lost against VJ and Eagle too.
Yeah.
So and I was like, what? What happened? But Android, I have a hard time dealing with Android teams.
I'd
rather team with that guy than have him against me so much, you know? He really know how to zone me out so well.
Yeah, it can be really tough. I remember the last set I played with him, I learned a lot about his playstyle.
Yeah,
really impressive.
I know me and Chris, the Norwegian Sheik player, we have pretty good synergy, I would say.
Yeah.
And we did drop one set to Android and Solar teams, and almost the second one as well. It went to like game 5, second set.
I remember that.
And I was switching back between Peach and Fox, you know, because I wasn't really sure.
Yeah, Android.
And this
Android
time I played Fox against them.
Yeah, that's. He's a monster in teams. He really. It's really heartbreaking to play versus him and Zolar in teams, because he just saves Zolar over and over and over and over again. You can never kill any of them. And every single time when you go to the edge to try to, you know, interrupt him from saving Zolar, he somehow turns it around to an edge guard on both me and my teammate.
He's so good. I would love to team with him at least one more time in America.
Yeah, you guys would win.
Now?
I'm calling you right now. If you guys team, you will win.
Yeah, I think Hungerbox and Plop would be our biggest problem. But except for that, I honestly think us winning would not really even be an upset.
No, I don't think so either. But like I said, I'm calling it right now. You guys will win if you play in America again.
Yeah, I need to better up my Fox though, because Hungerbox Plop is gonna be hard.
Yeah, but
I can't.
I'm calling it.
Okay, yeah. Thanks for the faith, dude. Yeah. I really think we have a shot. Like, Andrew is so good in teams, like, such awareness. And the last time we teamed, we placed fourth. But that was like slightly before Android started to improve a lot, and I was, you know, pretty rusty for the time being.
Yeah.
So now I feel like it would be so cool, and people would maybe finally be like, oh my god, because
because the thing is, like, it's really ridiculous. Like, all of those team combos that that you see in these videos, like, and people are super hype over it, it's like, us in Gothenburg, we see it every day. Like, when you and Android team, it's fucking brutal.
Yeah, we have a pretty high accuracy.